Well, haven't got a new light yet, so looks like we're back to the drawing board. I'm Jonnay, so let's do some macrame. Today, we're going to talk about one of the most important synthesizers, and I'm not exaggerating here, in the 20th century, the TB-303, in under 4 minutes. That's the thing that's making this rolling, squealing, squelching sound in the background. I'm going to show you some key tracks, links in the doobly-doo. Some special shoutouts go to Stay Up Forever Records, amazing 303 acid techno. And I know there are some serious acid junkies that are watching this right now, so feel free to fire me your favorite tracks in the comments. We'll start with a bird's eye view. We have a VCO, a VCF, an envelope generator, and a VCA. We're talking about voltage controlled whatevers. So all these things combine together to create a synthesizer, not just a TB-303. Almost all synthesizers have these basic things. So let's start with a VCO, voltage controlled oscillator. It's basically a fancy schmancy way of saying analog sound generator thingamabobber. All right, so we start with this digital analog converter. It takes notes from the digital sequencer and turns it into a voltage. And for a 303, it goes through this thing called the slide circuit. This is one of the character builders of the TB-303. What happens is that you have a note like C, and then it goes to the note D. Now, normally it's just a jump from these two different voltages, but with the slide on, it takes a while for the jump to happen. So it's like the slow rise. That all happens on one little thing called a capacitor. And these things are not perfect. There's tolerances, maybe badly machined parts, they wear out. So each TB-303 has a capacitor with a slightly different capacity, which is why they're called capacitors, to hold a charge. So each 303 has its own character. So now we have a pitch. It may or may not be slid, which gets fed into this weird temperature compensation circuit, and then it gets fed into the silicon controlled rectifier. Okay, there's lots of super electronic nerd things here going on. There's two fundamental things that you should know here. First of all, what's being generated is a saw wave, and the shape of that saw wave is based on how saturated the transistors are. So it cuts off the tops. And transistors, again, different production runs, so they have different tolerances. So what this really means is that the saw wave of the TB-303 is fundamentally different from a normal saw wave. Now, admittedly, not in a large way, but this also means each 303 is going to be different. So we have a saw wave. Hey, but the fun don't stop, because there's a little switch. It can make a saw wave or it can make a square wave. And the square wave is not what it says on the tin. What's going on is that the charge is going through this thing called a wave shaper to turn the saw wave into a square wave. But again, the fundamental piece of this wave shaper is a transistor. It's going to be different. And in particular, the wave shaping transistor has such an effect on the character of its sound that in the clones, they had tried to source the original components. There's our oscillator. We get a digital signal in, and then we get a saw and possibly a square wave going out. What's next on our list? The voltage controlled filter. Just for a bit, we're just going to delve into some sound nerdism. So hold on to your pants. A filter, well, it just filters out part of the noise. Just to make things super easy, they're named after the stuff that they don't filter. A low pass filter filters the high frequencies and passes the low frequencies. The TB-303 has this low pass filter. Now this thing, this filter is very weird, and it's full of transistors. You know, those things I keep saying, production runs different. Yeah. So now we have a filter on our sound, but there's one more essential piece, and that's the envelope generator. Now, I talked a little bit about envelopes in the compression video. They're what give a sound its shape and its movement. A percussive sound like a drum is going to be way different than a string bass or a violin. An envelope doesn't do anything on its own. It modulates other things, mostly the filter and the amplifier. The TB-303 has a simple attack release envelope. The thing about the 303 and its envelope is that there's a special accent mode. And due to the design of the accented filter, it doesn't quite reset itself. The accented filter keeps going higher and higher and higher. It's been likened to an animal in distress. So this envelope doesn't make sound on its own. It's just a control value that gets fed into the filter and into the amplifier. Now, amplifiers are actually kind of boring. They just take a signal and amplify it with some other modulating signal. Bam. That's it. So all these components come together as squelchy TB-303 goodness. The big thing here is that there's lots of weird design trade-offs. Capacitors get plugged in backwards, solder is slowly corroding, transistors are slowly dying. To what extent does this affect the sound? This is part of the character of a synthesizer, and this is part of the character of my favorite synthesizer, the TB-303. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know what you think. What's your favorite synthesizer? I'd like to know. to all the people that have been commenting and liking and sharing. Again, I want to thank you. You guys rock.